You are the lifeguard on duty at the local municipal pool. You are trained in basic life support. Across the pool, you see a group of teens pushing and shoving each other. As you are about to intervene, one of the teens is pushed into the pool. He strikes his head on the side of the pool as he falls in and sinks to the bottom. One of the teens reacts quickly, diving in and pulling the injured teen to the surface, where his friends help him pull the injured teen out of the water. They lay him at the edge of the pool just as you reach them. Yelling at the teens to call 911 and bring the AED from the office, you quickly assess the teen for responsiveness. The teen does not respond when you shake his shoulder and ask loudly if he is okay. You scan his chest for breathing. There are no visible respirations. What is the next intervention? Check for a carotid pulse. Check the carotid pulse on the side closest to you using the index and middle finger on your dominant hand. You should check for a pulse for 5 to no longer than 10 seconds. You do not feel a pulse within 10 seconds. What is your next intervention? Begin chest compressions. Landmark by placing both hands, one on top of the other with the fingers interlaced, between the nipples and just slightly below the nipple line. Compress the center of the chest, lower half of the sternum, allowing the chest to return to its natural position in between compressions. How fast should compressions be given in the adult patient? Compressions should be given at a rate of 100 to 120 compressions per minute. How deeply should the chest be compressed in the adult patient? The chest should be compressed to a depth of between 2 and 2.4 inches, about 5 centimeters. You provide 30 compressions at the rate and depth described above. What is the next intervention? Open the airway and give 2 breaths. What maneuver should be used to open the patient's airway in this scenario? The jaw thrust maneuver should be used to open the patient's airway. If you suspect a head or spinal cord injury, you should use the jaw thrust maneuver to open the airway to avoid further injury to the spinal cord. Using the head tilt chin lift maneuver on a patient with a spinal cord injury could cause permanent injury. You continue giving CPR for another cycle of compressions and ventilations until one of the other lifeguards arrives carrying an AED. He quickly sets the AED beside you, next to the patient. He tells you that he will continue CPR while you operate the AED. What is the next intervention? Turn the AED on by pressing the on button. Some AEDs will automatically power up when the lid of the AED is lifted. Fully automated AEDs. Semi-automated AED requires you to push buttons to operate the machine. Quickly dry the chest if it is wet. The patient in this scenario is a drowning victim, so the chest would likely be damp or wet. However, the chest does not need to be completely dry, and you should not delay shock delivery to dry the chest. You quickly wipe the patient's chest with a towel. You attach the adult pads to the patient's chest, placing one pad to the left of the nipple on the left side, about 2 inches below the left axilla, and one pad to the right of the sternum, just below the clavicle. You attach the AED connecting cables to the AED machine. The patient must be cleared during analysis, as any movement will hinder the AED's ability to read the patient's rhythm. Ensure that no one is touching the patient during analysis. You should clear the patient verbally, i.e., state "clear" loudly, while looking to ensure the patient is not being touched by anyone, including yourself. You clear the patient. The AED analyzes the patient's rhythm, and a mechanical voice states, "Shock advised." What is the next intervention? Clear the patient and push shock. To clear the patient before shocking, state, "I am going to shock on three. 1, 2, 3, shocking." Then push the shock button. Make sure to visually check while clearing the patient to ensure that no one is touching the patient, including you. You push the shock button. The patient's muscles jerk, then relax. What is the next intervention? Resume CPR, starting with compressions, at a ratio of 30 to 2. You and the other lifeguard continue providing CPR, analyzing and shocking the patient as advised for 2 cycles of CPR. You switch off during every rhythm analysis to prevent fatigue, which can lead to poor quality compressions. When you analyze the patient's rhythm for the 4th time, the AED states, "No shock advised." What does this signify? The patient is in a non-shockable rhythm. If the AED announces that no shock is advised, what should you do? The ambulance arrives and the crew takes over. They quickly establish IV access and administer epinephrine 1 mg. After an additional shock, a weak and slow carotid pulse of 45 beats per minute is palpated. Compressions are discontinued and ventilations continue to be provided. At what rate should ventilations be provided? One ventilation every 6 seconds. The patient in respiratory arrest is given ventilations at a rate of one ventilation every 6 seconds, 10 breaths per minute. This is different from the rate provided to the patient in cardiac arrest. The patient remains unresponsive and apneic with a pulse of 45 beats per minute. One of the paramedics takes the patient's blood pressure and finds that it is 80 systolic by palpation. Ventilations are being provided with an ambu bag connected to 100% oxygen. What is the next intervention? Administer atropine. The patient is bradycardic and is profoundly symptomatic. Therefore, administering atropine is appropriate. Atropine is administered. The patient's heart rate increases and the patient's pulse becomes stronger and much easier to palpate. The patient begins to make weak respiratory efforts. The crew continues to assist the patient's breathing, supporting ventilations with an ambu bag connected to an oxygen source. The crew applies warm blankets, and the patient is loaded into the ambulance and transported to the nearest hospital.